Good morning, children. So our next topic is the sixth chapter, Pythagorean triplets. So what is meant by Pythagorean triplets? Actually, this Pythagoras theorem. From Pythagoras theorem, we got this Pythagorean triplets. That theorem you are going to learn in 10th class. But before going to that, what are Pythagorean triplets? Triplets means three numbers. So we can consider three numbers if sum of squares of any two numbers is equal to square of the third number. Then those three are called as Pythagorean triplets. Okay, if you want, I'll give you one example. Okay, so if you consider 5, 12, 13, find first of squares of these three numbers. 5 square 25 12 square 144 and 13 square 169. Now see, if you observe here, if you add these two, 25 plus 144 is nothing but 169. 25 plus 144 is equal to 169. That means 5 square plus 12 square is equal to 13 square. Sum of squares of these two numbers, sum of squares of 5 and 12 is equal to square of 13. So that's why we call these three numbers 5, 12, 13 as Pythagorean triplets. Okay. Okay. Then also we have no common factor is there in between. See, in 6th class we have learned about coprimes. If the common factor of any two numbers is 1, then they are called as coprimes. If here, if the common factor of any three numbers is 1, then they are called primitive triplets. Okay. That is not necessary here. Just I am saying primitive triplets. Okay, so this is about the Pythagorean triplets. Next we have square roots. Okay. Next is square roots. So what is meant by square roots? So in the previous class we have learned about square numbers. The reverse process of squaring is called a root. Square root. See, if I say 3 into 3, you know that 3 into 3 is 9. That means 9 can be written as 3 square. 9 can be written as 3 square. So 9 is a square number which can be written as the product of two equal factors. What are the two equal factors? 3. Now here this 3, the equal factors, one of the equal factor is called as square root of 9. 9 is square number of 3 and 3 is square root of 9. 3 is here, 3 is square root of 9. Same, 4 can be written as 2 square. So, 2 is the square root of 4, reverse. Okay, reverse of a square number. 4 is written as 2 square. With what number we are writing it as square, that number, that factor is called as square root. Here 2 is the square root of 4. And if I take 144, which is 12 square, so 12 is the square root of 144. And how do you define this square root? The symbol for square root is square root. Now we can write it this as symbolically. We can write square root of 9 is 3. Square root of 9 is 3. And square root of 4 is 2. And square root of 144 is 12. This is in words we have written, and here it is in symbolic form. Square root of 9 is 3. With what number? This 9 is formed by multiplying 3 two times. So that 3 is called as square root of 9. And here 2 is called square root of 4. And 12 is called square root of 144. And if you want, square root of 25 is 5. Square root of 16 is 4. Okay. So like that you can write up. How many? Square root of 64 is 8. Square root of 81 is 9. Reverse. Okay. So this is called square root. Now this we know directly. If they have given a big number, how to find square roots. This is also notes. I'll give you afterwards. Okay. So here we have an easy method of finding square roots using prime factorization method. That I'll explain to you. Prime factorization method. How to find square roots using prime factorization method. We have a successive subtraction method, but that won't be useful for you. So I'll explain only prime factorization method. Finding square root using prime factorization method. So for example, this you have to note down, prime factorization method. Okay, finding square root using prime factorization method. Okay, let us consider 1296. We have to find square root of 1296. So how to find square root of 1296? For the previous questions, they are one digit and two digit numbers, so you know already how to write them as square, so you did it easily. But here a big number is given, four digit number, and then further they may give 5 or 6 or like that. So how to find the square root means we have one method. First method is prime factorization method, and second method is division method. First you should learn about a prime factorization, and then we'll go for division in the next class. Okay, so first a prime factorization method. You know already in 6th and 7th class you have learned about how to do prime factorization. So start with here also you should go with the prime factorization. Start with the prime numbers. You have to start with prime numbers, no? So start with 2. 2 6s are, 2 4s are, 2 8s are. Again 2. 2 3s are, 2 2s are, 2 4s are. Again 2. 2 1s are, 2 6s are, 2 2s are. 2 8s are, 2 1s are. Now this is odd number, so we cannot take 2. So next prime number 3, we consider 3. 3 2s are, 3 7s are. Again 3 9s are, and 3 3s are. So until we got a prime number, it is enough to do prime factorization. So at the end we should get a prime number. Until then we have to do the factorization. Now we got all the prime numbers. Now this can be written as 1296 can be written as, multiply all this. 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 3 into 3 into 3 into 3. Okay, 1296 can be written as 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 3 into 3 into 3 into 3. Okay, now we have to find, what we need to find, we have to find square root. So for that, what you have to do is make them into groups or make them into pairs. 2 2. What I said in this, writing squares, we have to write. Square number means we have written in squares, so 9 means 3 square we have written. So like that, we have to make them into pairs. See here. This I'll write like this. 2 2. 2 2 numbers, same numbers as a pair. 1 pair into, again 2 into 2. Again 3 into 3. And 3 into 3. So I have made them into pairs. 2 2 numbers means pair. So 2 2 same numbers as a pair we did. Now we have to find square root. We need to find square root of 1296. This is 1296 total value, that is. We need to find square root of 1296. So square root of 1296 is equal to, after making them into pairs, what you have to do is, from each pair you have to take one number. See, from this only take 1, 2, and again from here 1, and from here 1, and then from here 1. Instead of pairs, while writing square root you have to consider only 1. Now multiply it. 2 2s are 4. 4 3s are 12. 12 3s are 36. So square root of 1296 is 36. If you want, you can multiply 36 into 36. If you find 36 into 36, you will get 1296 only. So this is the process of finding a square root of a number using prime factorization method. What you have to do is simple. First you should go with prime factorization and write it as a product, product of its factors, and then make them into pairs of the same factors. Don't go 2 into 3 as a pair. Okay, they are not a pair. Same numbers must be as pair. 2 2 2 2 3 3 3 and then enter. Don't forget that if it is a perfect square or if it have a square number, then you'll get a perfect pairs, perfect number of pairs, exact number of pairs you will get. Okay, don't confused in that. Okay, if it is not a perfect pair, then only you'll get a non-sync of pairs. Here exact number of pairs you will get. Okay, so see how many pairs you got. 4 pairs you got. From each pair you have to take one factor. As it is same factors we have, so from those same factors you have to consider only one factor. From 2 into 2 consider 1, and here 1, and here 1, and here 1. So what is the answer? 36. So square root of 1296 is nothing but 36. So this is what, which method? This is prime factorization method. Okay, now let me explain one example so that fifth and sixth example I will explain so that you can do exercise 6.2. okay, this you have to note down in your reference mark. Now example 5, find the smallest number by which 720 should be multiplied to get a perfect square. So what they have given, they have given that one number is given. What is that? 720. One number is given and that they already mentioned that it is not a perfect square. That means you are not going to get exact number of pairs. You are not going to get exact number of pairs. Now what they asked, find the smallest number by which, with what number if you multiply this 720, it will become a perfect square. So to know that, again same here also, what you have to do, you should go with the prime factorization only. So go with prime factorization first, 720. As it is an even number, start with the 2. 2 3s are, 2 6s are, 2 0s are, 2 1s are, 3 8s are, 2 0s. 290s, 245. So it is odd number, so go with 3. 3 ones are, 3 fives are, 3 fives. So we got a prime number. Now this can be written as 720 is equal to 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 3 into 3 into 5. That's it. 1, 2, 3, 4, yes. Now make them into pairs. First 2 2 into 2, okay, it is a pair. Again 2 into 2, it is a pair. Next again 3 into 3, it is also a pair. But if you observe here, only 5 is left to get a perfect square. What I said, they must be in exact number of pairs. But here see, 3 are in pairs but 5 is alone. So to be a perfect square, 5 must have another 5 so that it become a pair. So what is the number that we need? What is the number that we need? We need one more 5. We need one more 5 so that it becomes a pair. So what we need here? Therefore we need one more 5 to get a perfect square. To get a perfect square, we need one more 5. Therefore, what is the number we need? Therefore, the required number, what they have given? The required number is 5. The required number is 5. And also, do we need to find the number? Okay. Therefore, the number that obtained, see, after multiplying with 5, what is the number you are going to get? 720 into 5, 3600. So, this 3600 is a perfect square, but 720 is not a perfect square. So whenever you are doing, if they asked what is the extra number that must be multiplied, what is the extra number that must be multiplied or the extra number that must be divided, if they asked, means what are the number alone you got, that will be the answer. Here 5 is alone, so we need one more 5. So we need one more 5. So the required number is 5 that we have to write. This is example 5. And let me explain example 6 also, so that I can give you homework from exercise 6.2. Exercise 6.2 total is homework for you. I'll explain all the problems. Don't worry. I'll give you hints, but you have to do total problem. Okay, 6th example. Find the smallest number by which 6000 should be divided. See, the previous question they have given multiplied, and here they ask about divided. So both are same. You are going to get the same value, but the obtained number will be different. Okay, the process is same, whether it is divided or multiplied. Remember, whether it is multiplied or divided, only for multiplied and divided. Okay, remember this. Why? Because the next exercise I am going to explain another process. There you won't get this multiplied and divided. Okay, so remember, after when multiplied and divided is given, you should go with prime factorization method. So here our number is given. What is that number? 6000. Given number is 6000. So we have to find a number which must be divided. Divide this 6000 so that it becomes a perfect square. 6000 is not a perfect square. So we have to find that number with what we have to divide this 6000 so that it becomes a perfect square. So for that again you should go with the prime factorization. So 6000, as it is an even number, start with 2. 3000 and then 1500 and then 2 7s, 2 5s, 2 0s, 2 3s, 2 7s, 2 5s. Now we got an odd number, so go with the 3. 3 1s, 3 2s, 3 5s. Now again 125 is an odd number, but it is not divisible by 3, so go for 5. 5 2s, 5 5s, 5 5s. Okay, now the 6000 can be written as 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 3 into 5 into 5 into 5. Again, so whatever you do, should go with the pairing. So go pair them, 2 2, 1 pair. Again 2 into 2, another pair. This 4 completed. Next 3, 3 is alone. So leave it. 5 and 5. Yeah, again we have one more pair. What are left here? 3 and 5. 3 and 5 left. So last time, right? See, this is one pair, this is one pair, and this is other pair. What are left alone here? 3 and 5 are left alone. They are not a pair. One is 3 and one is 5. Both, if they are same, then only we can make them as pair. But here, 3 is alone, 5 is alone. So we have to remove those 3 and 5. So 3 into 5 is how much? 3 5s are nothing but 15. If you remove that 15, how to remove that 15? By dividing it by 15. If you divide this total number by 15, you can remove 3 and 5. You can remove 3 and 5. If you divide this total by 15. So what is the required number we need here? 15. Yes. Since 3 5s are 15. Since 15 is extra here, we need to remove 15. That implies the required number that is to be divided is 15. Okay, the required number is 15. Now what will you get? The number obtained after dividing. Six thousand by 15. 15 ones are 15 fours. So nothing but 400. Now do you know what is the square root of 400? You can say directly square root of 400 is equal to 20. Square root of 4 is 2 and square root of 100 is 10. So 2 times are 20. So square root of 400 is 20. If you don't know, again you should go with the prime factorization and then find the square root. Okay, so this is division and the previous problem is multiplication. So with this we have completed example 5 and 6. And now let me explain exercise 6.2 so that you can write them in homework. Okay, so first bit is exercise 6.2. First bit is finding the square roots using prime factorization method. So that you have to do simple way. Whatever the first example I have given, same like that you have to do. Find the square root of the following numbers by prime factorization method. So that already I have explained you. That is homework for you. Second one, find the smallest number by which 3645 must be multiplied to get a perfect square. This is like example 5. And again, find the smallest number by which 2400 is to be multiplied to get a perfect square. So for every number, after finding the required number, the number obtained you should find, and then you should write the square root of that number. Okay. So this is also same like fifth example. And then find the smallest number by which is to be divided. Fourth problem is like example 6. And now fifth problem. See here, fifth one. 1521 trees are planted in a garden in such a way that there are as many trees in each row as there are rows in the garden. Find the number of rows and the number of trees in each row. So for up to 4 already I have explained you. Now see, this is fifth one will be useful for the remaining all problems. Okay, only last one I will explain you in the next class. Up to 8th problem you have to do. One example I will explain here. Okay, fifth one. This is also half only I will explain. Remaining you have to do. Okay. So here what they have given, 1521 trees are planted in a garden in such a way that there are as many trees in each row as there are rows in the garden. So here, this is a garden. These are the number of rows. Number of rows. How many rows? We don't know. Let it be X. Number of rows, X. Then what they did? They did that they kept whatever the number of. So what they have given in fifth problem? So number of whatever the number of rows are there, that many trees are planted in each row. See, in a classroom or there is a meeting going on and we have to make the students sit like this. Three rows. In three rows we have to make them to sit. Three rows. In each row, three students should sit like this. Three rows are there. In each row, three students. Total three rows. Three students. Here 1, 2, 3. Total 3. So, total number of students. How will you get total number of students? If you count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. You are getting 9 students. So, instead of counting, if you do like this. 3, 3 is 9. You will get the same answer. Yes or no? Like area of a square. Here 3 and this is also 3. Both are same number. The length is same. So, if you multiply this, you will get the area. Same like that. Here also, what they have given? Number of rows are same and in each row, number of trees are same. So, total number you will get by multiplying these two. So, using that, we have to find the answer here. Let number of trees is equal to X. And the number of rows. Number of rows X. And the number of trees in each row. Again X. So total number of trees. X into X. Nothing but X square. But given. Given number of trees. Is 1521. It implies X square is equal to 1521. So if X square is 1521, then X is, see here we have written 3 square is 9, then 3 is under root of 9. Yes or no? We have written. We are writing square roots. 3 square is 9. Then 3 is square root of 9. So here also is x square is 1521. Then x is square root of 1521. That means you should find the square root of 1521. So obviously what you have to do, you should go with the prime factorization. Go with prime factorization. If you want to, let me explain that also. 1521. 3, obviously. 3 5s are 7s are 3 1s are 10s are. So 13, 13s are. Directly. 169 means 13, 13s are. Both are prime numbers. Okay. So 1521 is equal to 3 into 13 into 13. What I said? To find the square root, first you have to make them into pairs. 3, 3, 1 pair, 13, 13, 1 pair. So, 15, 21 is nothing but square root of 15, 21 is take 1 from here, take 1 from here. How much it is? 39. But 15, 21, square root of 15, 21 is nothing but x. Therefore, x is equal to 39. Therefore, number of trees in each row. 39. And the number of rows also 39 rows. Okay. So this is fifth problem. Now 6th is same. 6th is same. So the number of students, I think. 6th is a school collected 2601 fees. If fee paid by each student and number of students in the school is same. See, number of students is x and fee paid by them is also x. Then total fee is x into x. Same x square, and they have given the amount as 2601. So equate them and same process. 6th also same and 8th also same. Number of rows x, number of soldiers in each row x. Same like that. 8th also. Let me explain 7th one. 9th I'll explain in the next class. Okay. Let me explain now 7th problem. 7th also very easy one. But okay, somewhat different they have given. The product of two numbers is 1296. If one number is 16 times the other, if one number is 16 times the other, we don't know that number. So let the number be. X. Then other number. 16 times means 16 into x. 16 times means 16 into x. And their product is given. Product of these two numbers is given as 1296. 1296 only. Yes. That implies x into 16 into x is equal to 1296. Product means multiplication only, no? So here one number is there. So take this number to this side. X into x is equal to 1296. When multiplication goes to other side, it will become division. 16 ones are 16, 80 ones are. X into x is nothing but x square is equal to 81. Then x is equal to under root of 81. And you know already square root of 81 is nothing but 9. So x is equal to 9. Therefore, the numbers are 9 and 16 into 9. 69s are 144. Okay. This is the end. So you have homework. First bit. First, second, third, fourth, sixth and eighth. Okay. Ninth, I will explain in the next session. Okay. Have a good day.